Hello, so determination of iodine value, after doing the titration, then we will see that observation. So how will you calculate that iodine value? So in first observation, we have to how much gram of oil or fat taken for this titration, we have to calculate it by this way. So first we have to take the mass of weighing bottle. Suppose that is the empty weighing bottle is M1 gram. Then you pour that required quantity of oil in that bottle and take the weight of the bottle plus oil is equal to, suppose for example it is M2. Then mass of the bottle after transferring the oil is equal to 3. So then exact weight of sample or oil will get by weight of this M2 minus weight of M1 is equal to the X gram. That is the exact quantity of sample we have taken for this titration purpose. Then we will see that observation table. So for blank experiment, in that blank experiment we have to take 3 reading. So in the conical flux, we have to take that volume of how much quantity of ICI solution you have taken, that quantity. Then this solution, we have to titrate it, added that star solution as an indicator. Then their solution, we have to titrate it against sodium thiosulfate solution, M/10. Before starting that titration, you have to take that initial reading of burette, and that after titration, whatever reading will come, that should be right in a final volume of burette reading. So final minus initial will be the volume of sodium thiosulfate used in that titration purpose. Like this way, you have to take 3 reading. So that 3 reading divided by 3 will get that exact volume of sodium thiosulfate is required for this titration, a blank titration. Then second observation table, it containing that original experiment. That means here we have to take oil plus ICI solution, and that solution containing small quantity or 1 or 2 drop of star solution, then that will be titrated against M/10 sodium thiosulfate solution. So in that first test, so we have to take that volume of that oil sample plus ICI solution in a conical flux, that should be titrated against M/10 sodium thiosulfate solution, which is kept in a burette. So before starting that titration, we have to record the initial volume of burette reading. So, and then after titration, whatever result will come at the end point, that will be that final volume of sodium thiosulfate. Now the final volume minus initial volume, it will give the exact quantity of sodium thiosulfate is utilized for this titration purpose. Like this way, we have to take the 3 reading or more than 3 reading. If we will take more than 3 reading, we will get that accurate result, or maybe up to 3 reading also we will get somewhat accurate result we can expect. So after titration, then we will see that calculation. So the iodine value is given by the following formula, that is 12.69 into millimole of sodium thiosulfate into V0 minus V1, that is divided by X, where V0 is the volume of sodium thiosulfate used in blank titration, that means without any sample, whatever titration we have done, that reading we have to write here V0, and V1, that is the volume of sodium thiosulfate used in original titration, that means including sample. So, and M is the molarity of the sodium thiosulfate, that is M/10, that is 0.1, and X is the mass of the oil in gram. How much quantity of oil we have taken for this titration purpose, that should be influenced, that should be written here as X. So the result, the iodine value of the oil, we have to write the particular name of this oil. Whatever oil is given to you, that should be written here, was found to be like this way. We have to write that report also. Then thank you.